So, hi, hey, hello, YouTube. We are here with Bebe Stevens. My sheets are being washed. And I wanted to go over this Bushnell telescoping lens that you can use for cell phones and small pocket-sized cameras. I'm filming this right now on the Flip Minnow HD, but one of the ones that it does work on is the Kodak ZI-8. And originally, one of the first people that I saw was a channel called Noptop, and he has a lot of really good tutorial type videos on YouTube on film, and some on like kind of products that you can use or make on your own without spending, such high dollar. You don't always have to buy the high dollar products in order to, get the same kind of quality. So, anyways, when I first got this thing, I was kind of really, I put it together like a noob, pretty much. And so Noptop kind of explained a way that I kind of already knew, but I, again, I wasn't sure. So if you have one of these and you happen to have a Kodak ZI-8, the first thing that you're going to want to do, obviously, is you are going to want to put it on first, beforehand. You're going to want to slide it in. Now, the thing with this is there's a little adjustment knob that's here, so this part can slide back and forth. So basically, what you want to do is you want to get it to a point where it is kind of right in the middle here. And then what you're going to do is you're going to get that completely centered, make sure it's all the way pushed down. And also, another thing, which is kind of unfortunate, is that you can't get to the power button from here. So I've, I've used like a pen or something, anything really, just to kind of push the power on. But basically, what you want to do is you just want to get it centered, and then from then, you want to lock the ring. And sometimes, also, you see when I just did that, it moved. So you really want to kind of pay attention to getting it centered exactly where it is you need it. And when you're adjusting this and locking it, you're locking it from down here. So if it's going to move, it's going to come up this way and slide down. It's kind of like simple physics. So what I do is I just kind of hold it with my thumb, and you see now how that kind of holds it in place. Now what we're going to do is just going to grab like a pen or something and get in here on the side and turn the power button on. And so now the power button is on. You can see that. And now basically, you're just going to want to put it in and hold it in place because, again, it's not 100%. But so now you can see, can you see that now you can see with the actual lens, and there's no vignetting around the side or anything. You can kind of see a little bit right up in the corner. So again, it's not perfect science, but the point is to get this thing on and be able to use it for the telescoping effect. And I said in another video, first video, Butters, what are you doing? Why are you smelling my foot? Why are you smelling my foot? You want to be in a YouTube video, Butters? Huh? Do you want to be? You want to smell stuff? You want to be in a YouTube video? So, basically, that was my stop biting my foot, Plox, please, Butters, please. So, that was kind of the idea initially, was to show you this. Oh, what? That's not even what I was talking about. In the other video, I think that I said that I paid $15 for this. And when I look back at on my eBay account, I paid $4.99 for this thing. With free shipping. You heard me. Free shipping. So I paid $5 for this thing. And I'll put a link to Noptop's videos. He only has like one video with this. But basically the idea is to use this to get some depth of field with your Kodak ZI-8. So I will show you that. It's like 11:30 at night right now, and this little doggie is tired and Butters is biting my feet. So it is time for us to go to sleep right after I upload this because I'm anal retentive that way and I just can't. I just gotta, I gotta do it. I gotta do it. Good night, YouTube.